Would you attempt this trail in the rain, sleet, and snow? We were not expecting all this crazy weather today on the trail. We can't go back the way we came in because it rained all night. So, the only way out is up. Wish us luck.
All right, we just spent night two at the Hideout Campground. Let's see why they call it that. It took us about 2 hours to find it. Just little trails through the woods. We come down into this canyon. We're at about 5,700 feet right now. Got switchbacks coming all the way down in from one way and all the way out, as we drove back out and came back in trying to find the campground. They say campground, it's not what we're used to. It's pretty cool, but got a lot of rain last night. So, pretty sleepless. You're wondering if you're going to get up out of this muddy, slidey, slippery rocks and all this, so we kind of got a morning ahead of us trying to get out of here yet. Looks like the weather's changed pretty good for us, though. We got some blue sky clouds.
Yep. Crawling out of Hideout Campgrounds. It's hailing. We just got soaked, putting the tent away and everything away. And we got to go up about 2,500 feet up the switchbacks and slippery rocks, so it should be pretty cool.
The day before this, we had driven the Onion Creek Trail. If you haven't seen that video, there'll be a link at the end of this one, and I'll put a link in the description. At the end of Onion Creek, rather than turn around, we continued on towards Thompson Canyon and Polar Mesa to stay at the Hideout Campground. I wish you guys could see the descent angle here. Cameras just never really capture it very well.
This is where we missed our turn last night. We ended up going quite a ways up this trail before turning around to find camp. Having driven it, we were confident that we'd be okay heading up the trail today. Or at least Todd was. I'm Lisa from the View From Here Overland. If you're enjoying the video, please hit that like button. And if you want to follow along with our adventures, click subscribe.
Look at the view from here.
Fisher Valley 9, Highway 128, 21 miles.
The Sal National Forest, we just entered.
Perfect. Yep, I see that. I'm taking somebody else's track here. Now we know she will launch when you get after it a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Not a lot of it either.
God, I'm praying I'm not a-
midnight down at Moab. We're actually back to our original campsite that we drifted into the first night, because at least we knew where we were at and we could find it. But anyway, sun's setting behind me. Really cool, the sun's hitting all the hills in the background.